Hi, this is Sean. In this tutorial, I'm going to quickly go over how to set up an animation, bake it, and then send it to the Unreal Engine in a couple parts. So let's get started. So I've got this radar dish, and I've built it with some animation on it. I've also done a high-res model, which I'm going to use eventually to bake out some normal maps. But you can see it comes up, sets itself up, and then it starts to scan. So let's just quickly talk about a little bit of the things that we're going to do. So I'm going to hide the high-res version, don't need that. We can take a look at the bones. I'm going to switch to wire shaded mode. We've got some bones in here. Quickly, one thing for setting up some of the. When I bound this, one thing that's worth mentioning, I've got different pieces. I went and quickly used the component editor. And the component editor really makes it really easy to set weights for, especially for things like this radar dish, which, I have that segmented. So that's worth noting. What else? I've got keyframes set up from 1 to 150. One of the things that I found with the Unreal Engine is that I'm going to want to set my in my settings and preferences, I'm going to want to set up my settings to 30 frames per second. I found it was easier to get a more one-to-one correlation, but that's just something I've observed. So and then let's just take a look at how many frames we've got going here. So from about 0 to 105, 106 is the initial setup. And then 106 to 190 about, it does its search routine. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bake out the keys. And so you select the bones and you can go to Edit Keys, Bake Simulation. You can take a little look at the bake animation options. You want to make sure that you're baking everything below in the hierarchy, unless you really want to just do the selected bones. And we can choose the range, but I'm going to hit apply. So you can see it cycles through the animation. And what it's doing is it's capturing all the keys. And so now we have, even on some of these bones that didn't have any interpolated keyframes on it, it sets keys for all that. So there we are, we're good. So I'm going to export this twice. The first, I'm going to select this mesh. And I'm going to make sure I'm at the top of the hierarchy. I'm hitting the up arrow. I'm going to go File, Export, Selection. Now, if you didn't bake the keys on your animation, you could go in and bake the animation in the FBX options, but I just found that this works fine this way. So I'm going to call it Radar Dish 1, and I'll export the selection. Make sure that you're using the previous year FBX options. And so now let's bring that into Unreal. So I've got a skeletal mesh folder already set up. I'm going to hit import, radar dish one. I am going to. So now, since I want to bring this into two as two animations, so I'm going to set up, choose a set range. So from frame 0 to 105. And I'll say import all. So let's take a quick look at what we've got. We got the material that came with it. We've got the object. We've got a skeleton system, and we've got the animation. And so if we open it up, there's the mesh. It's a skeletal mesh. And then if we double click it, hold on, let me just drag this into the view. You can see the setup routine. Okay, great. So now let's do the other part. If you're going to do multiple animations that you're going to export, when you do the additional animations, you can just select the bones. And let's just go File, Export, Selection, and we'll save that as Radar Dish 2, Export Selection, replace that. Let's go back to the Unreal Engine and import the Radar Mesh 2. So now the second one now is you can see that it's got a different slightly different menu. And because I didn't really need to bring in the mesh anymore, I can assign this to the radar dish skeleton, and then I'm going to choose the animation set range, and we'll say 106 to I think it was 190, 188, 189. Okay, and there we go. Let's say import all. There we go. Let's double check that we've got. Okay, it looks like it's scanning correctly. Great. So now let's bring the radar dish into our scene and let's tell it to play the different animations on different key bindings. So let's just do it from the level blueprint at this point. So we've got the mesh selected. So I'm going to create a reference to that. And then I'm going to say play animation. Let's play skeletal mesh animation. And what animation am I going to play? It's called Radar Dish 1. So we'll say on the L key, it will play the setup animation. But if I hit the Let's copy and paste that. If I hit the O key, then we will play the search animation and we'll say we want it to loop. So let's radar dish 2. There we go. So let's compile that and close. Let's test. So hit L. See the radar dish doing its setup routine, and then we hit O and it starts searching, and it should just keep repeating. So there you go, that's the basics of it. We're not going to get into some of the other advanced features, which would be like the fat material physics actor asset that comes in with it. We'll save that for another video. But that's the basics. Thanks so much for watching.